Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and today I'm in London at Gibson's beautiful London showroom. PMT are hosting the Kramer Made to Rock Hard Live in London event, and we have some amazing bands on the bill. One of which being Bang Bang Romeo. How's it going, folks?
Oh, hey man, we're good. It's so good to be here. Thank you for having us.
It's going to be an amazing night. So the folk out there that might not know your lovely music, it's the first time dipping their toe into Bang Bang Romeo. What do you do? What's your names? What do you play or sing?
Yes, my name's Stars. Lead singer, writer,
I'm Richard, and I play the drums.
I'm Ross, I play guitar, write songs too.
So you guys are kind of fresh COVID off a massive tour with Pink. How was that? It looked incredible.
It was very big, and it was very beautiful.
It was a stadium tour, wasn't it?
Honestly,
I mean, Pink's stage show is fantastic, so being a part of that, besides getting to play to all these amazing fans, must be pretty unbelievable.
It was just an absolute dream come true, wasn't it?
I was just seeing the whole setup, the stage getting set up every day, and the experience of just, seeing that whole crew and, and meeting everybody on
there. We're massive Pink fans as well, like, obviously. I grew up listening to Pink, like, for me, like, as a singer, total icon and inspiration.
She was a trailblazer.
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt. So it was just inspiring. So we were like, right, we also get to see her for free every night. So we were like, right, what's best here? But yeah, the whole experience was incredible and we learned so much.
With inspiring though, your music itself is pretty inspiring as well. How did the Pink fans receive your music?
Oh, thank you. I think we were very, very lucky. You know, the fans really kind of like, well, they're still coming to shows today and there's people traveling from Europe to come see us in the UK, which is, it's bizarre, but like the most wonderful bizarre because we're all, you know, just this one big family. And
We did a lot of dates in Germany and picked up a lot of fans. And after the Pink tour, we were supposed to be going back out there doing a headline across the UK and Europe. Sadly, didn't happen because of the old COVID situation. But there were a lot of people excited to see us going over there at the time. So hopefully that will happen at some point.
I mean, I don't want to dwell on the whole COVID thing too much, but how did you as a band kind of cope with this lockdown? Were you writing music? Were you using it as a time to actually relax? Because musicians don't often get a time to relax. What were you doing to keep your mind going during COVID?
Can I swear?
Yes.
I'm fucking miserable. No, it's one of those things. We had an incredible 2019. We did the Pink tour. Played with Sting, we built this fan base that are now still incredibly loyal to this day, and we had so many things planned for 2020. So when that hit, it was devastating, the same way it has been for everyone else in every other industry on the planet. No, so we all kind of like, we all felt sad and fucking miserable together, didn't we? I think the only way that we could counteract that is by locking ourselves away, writing like crazy, supporting each other, and you know, we detached from our record label during that time, which was also like, it was a great thing for us mutually, a breath of fresh air, because we couldn't go to the States where they were based. We were here in the UK, so it was like, right, fresh start, new break, let's do it. So yeah, wrote, kept our heads above water, and now here we are in the same room as people.
It's an amazing thing, and if you want to get in a room with Bang Bang Romeo, you're halfway through your UK tour at the moment, aren't you?
Yeah.
Sold out. Yeah. In some cases. You've got Manchester coming up next. Yeah. How's it been to get back on stage and play music again?
It's the best feeling, isn't it?
It is the best feeling in the world. Yeah. I think it's the one thing of the last 18 months that we have missed, because no amount of live streams or Zoom calls can really connect you with people. Mm-hmm. And that's what we love to do. The live stage is where we bring our best show.
Yeah.
It's where we sound the best, we feel. And it's where we're most at home. And I think just connecting with people again has been
there. And that's like brought over to like tonight. It's kind of like we're in a room full of people that love the same things, that need the same things to stay alive. Mm-hmm. And I think that's such a beautiful thing. And we can all like feed off that of each other. And like, tonight we're going to fucking eat. Like, do you know what I mean? It's one of those things where we're now back in a room with people that are into what we love. And
touch on the live show for a second there. Your live show is phenomenal.
Oh,
it's
thank you.
An amazing experience to watch. So once you finish watching this video, check out Bang Bang Romeo on YouTube, of course. But you are also slicing in your brand new single to the tour, the rest of the tour.
We've got a brand new song out called Walk Girl.
Walk Girl.
And it's kind of like, we're very lucky that in our fan base, we've got a lot of incredibly strong, powerful women from all different walks of life. Mm-hmm. And we're incredibly inspired by powerful women. Like in our intro to our set, we've got some incredible speeches, you know, like
Oprah's in there.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? So all people that completely inspire us. And I'm like obsessed with RuPaul's Drag Race and good friends of Morgan McMichaels. So
Morgan, season one.
Yeah,
I love Morgan McMichaels.
Absolutely.
Huge fan of Morgan McMichaels.
Hello.
If she ever watches this, amazing.
She will. Amazing. And yeah, so the whole scene we're in love with, and we wanted to bring a song out that is a dedication to just female empowerment and strong, beautiful women across the world, absolutely smashing the arse off the planet.
Yeah, without a shadow of a doubt. Well, you can see that in all the stuff you do. It's very empowering to just to see in general, let alone feel it, but to see it and to see the extent in which you're going to for this kind of amazing thing.
Thank you.
Besides that, though, amazing covers I've seen. When I listened to your cover of Seven Nation Army, as a huge Jack White fan and White Stripes fan, I was like, you gotta have something in you to try and cover Seven Nation Army, mind. But it's such a dramatic, beautiful thing. Where did the idea come across to cover Seven Nation Army?
We've been covering it quite a while. On the Pink Tour at the end of the set, we went into that, didn't we? And I always got the place going. Mm-hmm. And then we thought, you know, let's put this down on a record as well.
It was either that or Wonderwall by Oasis.
No, we do like doing covers. At the minute, we're doing Edge of 17 on our tour. We did Creep when we did a recording of that. So, yeah, it's something we always want to keep in the set. Doing
and just anything that we love. Anything that, you know, makes us feel a bit alive. And there's always that, it's fucking played to death. Like, I don't give a shit what you think.
It's played to death because people enjoy it.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. It's one of those things that makes everyone feel good. It's an absolute tune. It's written by a genius. And if we can perform it as often as we can, then we will. Just as long as he doesn't see it, it's fine.
We're on this stage.
Yes.
It's a Kramer night. Lots of Kramers on the stage as well. What guitars are tickling your fancy to look at?
I'll be back, I'll go get it.
Tonight I'm going to be using the Hot Rod. The Hot Rod, yeah.
My personal favourite.
Yeah, the same, it just jumped out at me, that one.
Yeah, so is that why you chose it? Just because you saw it and it looks...
I like a bit of flames.
Oh yeah. And you've got the Jersey Star.
This is purely because I'm a massive attention seeker and it's got my name on it.
So was Richie Sambora back in the day, so.
I just love the whole aesthetic of it. It's one of those guitars where it's so in your face yet understated.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? So the whole design is like very glam. It's retro, but then with the white finish, it brings it back and the gold and obviously stars on it. So that one.
Cracking. Well, I can't wait to see them on stage. To end, let the fine folk know what you've got coming up, where they can find you, and everything Bang Bang Romeo.
Thank you. So, yes, we're Bang Bang Romeo.
We're everywhere. If you want
so to what have you got coming up?
Three dates left on our tour. We've got Manchester, London, and Sheffield.
On the 4th, 5th, and 6th of November, so a week's time. Tickets are still available, but there's only a handful, so bangbangromeo.com is the best place to find them. And if you search for Bang Bang Romeo, you'll find us everywhere else.
And because we've been asleep for the last year, the whole world has. Next year, it's going to be very loud and constant. And yeah, welcome to the BB Army.
All the songs you're writing as well. Any tasting of an album coming anytime soon? Like a new album from BB?
Yeah, we've got about two or three written.
Two or three albums written.
Yeah. One's really sad. No, we've got.
You can do a yin and yang. Have a happy album, have a sad album. Release it, for your good days and your bad days.
We've got our Adele breakup album. We've got that now. We're just writing and lots. And you know what? We're enjoying writing, and we're just going to keep bringing out songs on a freaking conveyor belt.
Fantastic. Well, I'm very much looking forward to it. Thank you so much for your time. Have a great gig.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. Thanks.
Cheers.
Cheers.